Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm Ud.
And I'm Mal.
And we are the hosts of Smoke, Scales, and Scribbles.
Yes, we are.
For our smoke part of our show that we have, we talk about smoking ganja with our friends. And smoking ganja with our friends at the time.
We get company, smoke a bunch of weed, it's a good time. Then we talk about a lot of our reptiles, and we educate you, and we learn new things, and we talk about ones we want, and our future ones, and our friends' ones, and all kinds of reptiles. And being a tattoo artist, we typically talk about some tattoos, because, like...
Hence the scribbles. Uh-huh. Anyways, we do a lot of talk of the three topics. We also talk about other stuff, things that have happened in our lives. We are a married couple, so it's kind of one of those things, that's how it goes.
We're a fun married couple.
So, that being said, if you have any children with you, if you don't think you're mature enough to be able to handle exactly what's being said, because we do talk about drug content, if that's, I mean, that's what people consider it, we don't, but, you know, please, this is not the podcast for you.
We are not children approved.
We have children, but no, we don't approve of them listening to our podcast, so.
They don't even know what the title is.
Alright, so, that being said, on we start. She's the artist.
And he's insane.
And together we're Smoke, Scales, and Scribbles. Ba-dum. What's going on, guys?
What's up?
No special guests today, sorry.
No, you're stuck with just us, sorry.
Just us. So, our audio hasn't been great the last couple of weeks, and I completely attribute that to the boy.
Yeah, it's not our fault. We've had to make do with the best we could.
So we've been trying to find what we call the lollipop, which has six auxiliary jacks attached to it that attaches to your phone's auxiliary jack or, you know, whatever kind of auxiliary jack you're going for.
That way my quiet self can be heard, you can be heard, our guests can be heard.
Right, we have multiple sets of headphones anyways that we hook up overall. I don't use a headset at all, I never have.
That's because you're loud as fuck.
I know. But like everyone else, that's the reason why you could hear me usually, but nobody else, because... We were trying to set up the headphones to shape or go towards different people, and it was a fucking mess.
It was a shit show, guys.
It was.
And
so,
we've tried the trick of just giving me a headphone and not you, and that doesn't work, because then it picks up only my voice.
And she's, like, screaming into the mic, it sounds like.
It's ridiculous. It's the only time in my life I sound loud.
Which I'm sure you've heard, if you've been listening to the show.
Yeah, Mal's the Queen.
Yeah.
There's a whole episode named Mal's the Queen, because that's all you can hear is me.
Yeah. So, some exciting news, some different news. For our podcast, we actually are changing our name from Ganja People to Smoke, Scales, and...
Scribbles.
And it's just me and Mal now. And then whoever decides to come for, like, a special, you know, just like a...
Come visit for the night.
Yeah. A little visiting session with us and you guys. We're going to continue to talk about everything we have, but instead of being just called Ganja People and talking mainly about weed, or trying to, and then we get off topic, and then get off topic, because we are stoners.
We're just going to embrace the off topic, along with the weed.
So, obviously, smoke stands for our weed. We smoke here. The scales goes for our reptiles, obviously, we talk about them constantly. And, of course, scribbles, as in the tattooing.
Yeah, baby.
So... I hope you guys like that. I hope it's not a pain in your ass once we do, because I'm going to change the name this week. I have all new stuff, I'm sure you heard at the beginning. So.
Let us know if you like it. It took us a minute to get it right.
We were high.
We were. Trying to say stuff in unison. That was great.
Yeah.
And then I forgot I was supposed to talk at one point.
Or like 3 points.
Yeah. Yeah, it was great.
Maybe someday we'll do a blooper reel.
It'd be freaking
with,
hilarious.
Like, a half-hour blooper reel of all the different shit we are doing. So, for the next piece of new information or new shit. So, we broke down, and since nobody came to Christmas, and nobody's come here since Christmas, that we bought Christmas presents for, a couple of the guys, of course. Mal says, fuck it. It's been, like, 60 days. They lost it.
It's mine now.
So, now we have two new pipes. I'm not sure what the fuck we're calling the one. She keeps calling it Karen Shrimp. Because it looks like Richard Shrimp. By the way, we are hitting the green hit of the night, just to let you know.
Sure.
Anyways.
Are.
So, yeah. So she's calling it Richard Shrimp, or Karen Shrimp, because...
Temporarily. I don't know if that's what we're going to keep.
It's very much like Richard Shrimp, but very much more prettier.
It's prettier, and it's so green. Like, I almost want to name it, like a something to do with green.
It's definitely, like, a really cool iridescent green.
It's beautiful. And I purple. Wanted to steal this when he brought it home. I didn't even want to give it to who it was for. And then they didn't show up, so guess what? That's fine.
And then the other one's Bickle, because it looks like a pickle. I mean, it's round, and then it has, like, little blotches, but it's blue, so...
It's a blue pickle.
It looks like a blue pickle. That is, like, a mini steamroller that really, I mean, it works just like a mini steamroller, too.
It's lovely.
If I'm being completely honest.
These people missed the fuck out on some nice pipes.
Yeah, because Jordan got his pipe.
Yep.
And Jordan loves it. Saphira. I actually remembered good it for job. Once.
We gave Red his.
And, yeah, he really likes his, too. At least, last I knew.
Last I knew. And then, that was it.
Yeah. The other three didn't show up.
We gave one of them to a friend of ours that didn't have a pipe, but needed one.
His ex-girlfriend broke his pipe by accident.
By accident.
And then, well, she dropped it, which, I mean, we've seen people drop shit before, you know.
That bitch was crazy. I'll put money that she actually did it on purpose.
So that way she couldn't smoke weed anymore herself?
No, just to be a spiteful bitch.
I'm just saying, like, because she did drop it while they were smoking. You know what I mean? Like, I get it.
Let me blame her and hate her.
I know.
I don't even like her. I don't even know her. But she's a bitch.
This is Mal being, you know.
Me.
Psycho and... petty and
I'm not being petty. She's a fucking psycho that could have put him through the ringer from hell.
I'm pretty sure she already did.
Yeah, fuck her.
Goodness gracious. Bickle's a dick. Being that Bickle is brand new and we've only smoked about
three.
This is, I think, our third bowl out of him.
He's kind of an ass.
He is. But I really like the swirly on the end of him. That's really...
It's like a little star on the end.
He's blue and white.
He literally has a pickle core on the end.
Like that's the little blue. String end.
Yeah, that's blue.
Oh, man. So, yeah, we have a lot of shit going on. We'll take a picture of Bickle and... I mean, she's calling it Karen Shrimp so far. I don't know what it's going to end up being. Maybe... If you guys are interested, you see our picture of it. It's the green iridescent looking one. It's square, just like Richard Shrimp is. If you're interested in trying to name it for us, send us a message. Send us, you know, like
or a comment.
A comment. Put a comment on it. We'd love to hear from you guys.
I'd love to hear suggestions because, like, as funny as Karen Shrimp is, she's so pretty. She's too pretty to be a Karen.
The only thing that I don't like about her as a whole is that you can't, like, she doesn't get dirty. Like, you can't see her get dirty and get more beautiful. She's already beautiful to start, and that's that.
No, I think she'll get darker.
Very minimally, maybe.
I think you'll be able to see a change in her.
I don't think that much.
I do. I think you'll be able to see it.
Not like with Bickle, where, like, literally you could see, like, right here where it's already starting to change color.
I hope it's going to turn, like, a really pretty blue color.
I feel like it's going to be blues of some sort. I feel like it's going to be kind of dark blue, almost like how Moray looks.
Because
Moray was almost like this when we first got Moray.
Yeah.
So that'd be kind of cool.
Khalif is going to love this thing.
Not somebody I feel like we will see too often.
We already know.
Well, honestly, like, mainly he came out because Red was hanging out with us and whatnot, so, yeah.
Probably not. It's alright.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not worried about it.
Sorry for the wind tonight, guys. It's retarded. It's nice and warm out, at least.
It is.
It's almost like 50 degrees out.
I'm actually not cold right now. Like, I'm actually alright.
The problem is, it's fucking windy as shit today. Which, we fixed some of our plastic before we started because it was really whipping. So we fixed the part that was really whipping. And, yeah. Like, now it's just the end piece, and then the one side piece is a little dickish. Yeah, dickish. We'll call it dickish.
Mm. Are we going to tell them what we decided about Tinley, too?
Yeah, we can.
Not right this second.
We were going over our new news as, like, our new changes and new pipes and this and that.
And the plastic tapage.
We're telling them why we've been sucking lately. Like, yeah, so we didn't even mention, like, what actually happened with the lollipop. So,
oh, we didn't, no.
We call it the lollipop. Our son, so Mal asked all three of our kids, have you seen a circular thing with, like, a little cord, and you plug in headphones? And all the kids are like, nope.
The headphones were there, because we keep the headphones plugged into it, but that part wasn't. So I showed them the headphones. Where is the thing that was on this?
Right.
Where is it? Because, I mean, they're 3, 4... and 10.
All of them said, we haven't seen it. Okay.
We took it at that.
So, like, 3 days later, maybe or so. By the way, we were missing it for 2 fucking weeks. That we couldn't find it anywhere in our house. So, which is weird because we keep it in a particular spot. But it was the night that we had the new guy here. We got really fucked up and set it on the counter.
Yeah.
Set it with the headphones, and then when we put the headphones away, the lollipop was missing of some sort. And we didn't notice at the time because, well, we were really high the night before and didn't know.
Yeah, so we missed it.
So, at like 2 weeks of it being missing-ish, Mal gets in the boys' book bag, so that way, because she goes through every once in a while to make sure he's giving us all of his paperwork and shit like that from school.
And not taking things like his tablet to school again.
Yeah, he took his tablet to school, and, like, he likes to take shit he's not supposed to.
So occasionally I just take a peek and make sure there's nothing in there it shouldn't be.
And she finds the fucking lollipop.
Yeah.
So.
And then he lied to me about it. I was so pissed. The babies must have put it in there. No. Try again.
Yeah, so we got the lollipop back, as you can tell, because it doesn't sound like asshole.
No, we should sound much better this week.
Besides the wind whipping the plastic.
Yeah, minus that.
Which we only probably have about another month before we actually can take the plastic down, probably, I'm hoping.
What month is this?
February. It's mid-February. Usually somewhere like mid to end of March, so beginning of April. That's what usually when we take it down.
And I can start enjoying the sunshine again.
God damn, I got
I'm like a cat. I love just sitting in the sun.
Yeah, she's like a cat. She's a pain in the ass. She likes to knock shit over, make messes, puts her ass in your face, you know.
You like it when my ass is in your face, first of all. Second of all, I never knock shit over on purpose. It's always on accident.
Some cats do it on accident. Some do it on purpose.
I don't poop in a box.
No, in a bowl, though.
Yeah, but I flush it, I don't bury it. And I'm also not outside mousing.
Your cat doesn't go outside mousing, just saying.
That's because she's old and lazy.
Don't even mouse in our fucking house if there's one in our house.
I tried to get her to chase a laser pointer the other day. Just to see if she would do it, because she used to when she was younger. She loved laser pointers. No, she just stared at it and swiped at it from where she was at, but she wouldn't get up and chase it. I'm like, you fat, lazy bitch.
She's just getting old, that's all.
She is, I know. I don't want to accept that she's getting old. I had to switch her to soft cat food because she started losing weight and shit.
That was a while ago now.
I know. But.
So, alright, so now we can start getting into a talk of Tinley. Because I know this is going to be a conversation. A long conversation.
I'm so excited, guys. So fucking excited.
So, we just have one thing after another coming up that's costing us money. And obviously, Tinley's about a month away.
Just over a month away.
And, literally, she doesn't have anything saved, barely. I don't have anything saved. But, we already got our Airbnb, which I don't remember. I don't think we talked about the Airbnb last week. Because I had gotten the Airbnb last week. So we'll talk about that too tonight. Anyways, and then we already bought our VIP tickets for it. So that's like,
well, like I
the big expenses there besides the gas and then, of course, food.
The money I had started saving for Tinley, we used and bought the tickets so that we had them because we didn't know if they would sell out of them or how many they sold or anything, so we wanted to get those.
Right.
And then taking on Izzy and having to pay for her to go to bed and pay for this and that and that and this for her, that added up pretty quick. And then I had to make a large food order.
A large food order?
Yeah, a really large, like, rodent food order. So, you know, that's expensive. I only have to do it, like, every 3 months or so. But it's always expensive when I have to do it. And I couldn't put it off till after.
What's nice is you have a tattoo party coming up that the majority of that will go towards Tinley. I've been saving change, which when I work at the bar, I have a whole pocket full of change usually. So I've been putting that away every week. So, I mean, we have probably 20 pounds of change.
Oh, my God, yeah. More. And then I emptied my purse, all three of my purses, because I had three of them filled with stuff. Emptied all three of them and all my wallets and got all the change out of them and put that in there.
We're planning on buying all of our gas for the whole trip with just the change.
Yeah.
We're hoping there'll be a little bit of extra money to be able to buy
food.
Which, we're poor man in it, because we only had 4 months to plan this, and it's in Chicago, which, by the way, is a 10-hour drive for us one way.
And, of course, we had decided to try and plan it for right at the time of year where it's literally the hardest for us every single year.
Not to mention, like, we had Christmas in between, because we had heard about Tinley before October, and then somebody that we know said they went to Tinley, and they were talking about how awesome Tinley was, so we started doing some research, and we're like, oh, man. So, since October, we've decided we're going to go and gotten things around for it and tried to do our best for it, at least.
But our anniversary's in October, and then
Christmas, and then I've put, like, $1,500 into our two cars.
Yeah, minimum.
Just since the beginning of this year.
Yeah, that's not even including around Christmas and stuff. Plus, we had COVID, so we were out 2 weeks of work, which fucked us real good.
I spent an extra probably $1,000 around Christmas time beyond what I planned on spending.
Yeah.
So, like,
and then we have, you know, the other boy's birthday is coming. Just had your birthday.
My mom, her boyfriend's birthday. All those are all expenses and shit. We're like, fuck. So we haven't really been able to save any money. And then I put a deposit on Hannibal.
Yeah.
That's gonna be our new black and like
chocolate colored.
Yeah, like a really dark cinnamon brown.
Oh, he's so pretty.
He is. He's gorgeous. That's our male boa that I had to have. So I found him in December, and I've been watching him ever since. And then I was like, all right, I'm just doing this. Fuck it, I'm gonna do it. So we have so many fucking pots in our skillet, like so many different shit in our skillet right now in life, really.
I'm so excited. We're like making a stir fry with life right now.
Yeah. Some of it's good, some of it's bad.
I know you hate stir fry, but it was the only thing I could think of.
I just mean some of it's good, like some stuff is good, and some of it, I mean, like the car stuff, it's not necessarily bad. Like, it's not like we had to get a new car yet. Knock on wood.
Fucks the wood.
But, it's just like not planned expenses and stuff like that. Like
the stuff that we're trying to put off until Tinley's done.
Right. Ugh. So we're just, and shit's piling up. I mean, the boy broke our faucet the other day. The boy's bed broke the other day. I'm like, what in the fuck?
He broke two brooms, a bed, and a faucet in the spread of 3 days.
Like, yeah.
I'm like, dude, what are you doing?
And, I mean, the bed wasn't his fault. He was sitting on his bed practicing his trombone because I'm not sure why, but he really wanted to play the trombone this year. So, more power to him.
That's what he wants to do, so we're letting him play the trombone.
Currently, it sounds like
dying duck fart.
Yeah, it sounds like elephants dying and farting at the same time.
The baby thing is terrible, so.
Oh, I know.
He sits on his top bunk so that he can't, like, he's not in their face or anything. And practices. And he was literally just sitting up there, practicing, and the entire top bunk just collapsed. We were so grateful that the other boy wasn't laying on his bed at all.
Well, I mean, we had the babies leave the room. We call them babies, but they're
not
older. They're even older than toddlers now. I mean, one's in school. The other one will be in school here in like four
months.
They're
going to always be what I call the babies. You know that, right?
Right. So, anyways, we made them leave the room, and then we closed the door, so that way it was not quite as loud for all the reptiles in our house, as well as it's not that loud for the children. Of course, Mom doesn't want to hear super loud trombone noises.
Yeah, no, I'm good.
Yeah, so, wow, we're so bad stoners.
We are bad.
Like, we're so bad off the topic. Anyway, so it fell and he, like, freaked out. I'm like, it's all right. You're not hurt. It's not a big deal.
It scared the ever-living daylights out of him, though. And I can't say I blame him because I probably would have shit my pants.
Anytime that anything happens, he, like, freaks out. I'm like, chill out. It's okay.
I know. His fight or flight mode is nothing. It's freeze and panic.
And cry. I'm like, chill out.
Not even cry. Scream. Scream hysterically.
And cry.
It's, like, ridiculous. It's a little over the top. Like, that kid should get into drama school. He'd be good at it.
You're funny. So, anyways, all this coming up, we don't have a ton of money to go to Tinley with, and more or less, we were looking at it as an educational situation. And we had talked about, like, what we were looking at Tinley. I mean, we told you guys, you know, we were talking, like, probably close to a month ago about what we were interested in looking at Tinley. So, we were going through our options because of what we have for money. So, we know it's not going to be anything that is super expensive that we can afford there. So, we were thinking about stuff, and I had really had it on my mind hardcore for a while. And I was like, okay, so what fits in our categories of things that we want to get and we can fit in our house currently. So we're thinking, and the problem is we have two boas here after, like, Hannibal gets here, and we'll have a third one, which will take literally, like, a bookshelf size, like, house. Like, honestly. Like, a 6x2x2. Like, it's 2x3, yeah.
Yeah, big. Say no. It's bigger than 2x2. I couldn't remember what it was, so, but yeah, it's like
6x2x3. Yeah, so it's a big house eventually. I mean, it would be a few years, but still, like, it's going to be a big house eventually. So, trying to think of things that we could fit on racks, and I'm like, I don't even know. Like, trying to figure it out, and I got the idea because Mal really wants a monitor, stupid bad.
Oh my god, they're amazing.
Just because they're so trainable, they have so much personality generally, and they're actually really, really cool.
They're really smart.
So, she wants an Aki monitor. She has for a really long time, which takes a 4x2x2. Which isn't a huge... I mean, we have...
Honestly,
It's almost the same size as the 70 gallons, just a little bit wider and a little bit taller.
Honestly, it's probably one of the most reasonably sized animals I've begged to have. Usually what I want is massive.
Which is funny. I mean, it's one of the smallest monitors there is in the world. And they only get to be like 26 inches long head to the end of tail. Something like that.
I think the biggest they've ever found was like 30 inches, and that was a big one. You know what I mean? Like, that's really...
I'm sure it was probably in the wild, too, though.
Yeah, I don't know.
And so I was like, we could do this. So I was like, all right. So, I told her, I was like, what if we got an Aki while we were there? And she's like, are you serious? I'm like, yes. We'll get an Aki. Because Aki monitors go usually anywhere from $400 to $800, depending on the breeder and the coloring and the pattern and yada, yada, yada. So, and of course, when she finds an animal that she wants, then she, like, gets a click with it. Kind of like Clarice, just kind of clicked. Like, we both really liked her coloring, and she... really kind of clicked with us really quickly, so.
I have to have a feeling.
So I told her, I was like, as soon as we find the one that we have a feeling about, then we will buy it right then. Just because it is Tinley, there was thousands of people to go to Tinley. I don't want to miss out on that opportunity.
Yeah.
So it's something that's fairly cheap. Unfortunately, to house it is not fairly cheap, but if it's small, we have some... cages around the house that we could put it in to start, and then set up a temporary situation similar to like
Like a quarantine.
Like what Mocha has right now, just tipped on its side instead of standing up. They will be content in that for now until we can get actual... I mean, put some rocks in there for them to bask on, but eventually we'll have, like, an actual wall built and everything else, and it'll probably be a good, probably, midsummer by the time we actually get the enclosure that we want for it and get it built the way we want and learn how to fucking do it.
We're not gonna have to build it. That bitch comes assembled.
Oh, they do all the spray foam for you, too, and build all the fucking walls in it, and put your rocks in it, and all that shit for you, too? Oh, okay.
Shut the fuck up! I thought you meant assemble the entire cage, damn it.
No! Build the fucking cage! Like, build the shit in it for the fucking animal. Like...
I think we should spray foam some command hooks in there. Because those are great to hook hammocks on, hook vines on, whatever we need. Like, they're just great to have to be able to hook shit on.
I was going to say, they're never going to have a vine. they don't need a vine. They're a desert
But they
animal.
Could have a hammock.
A hammock is fine. But we'll figure something out, whether we put command hooks or, like, we find something that's sturdier.
Right.
By that time, whatever we find, I'm sure it'll probably be, like, mid-summer by the time we actually get... A 4x2 by 2, and then actually get it built. Because you have to do it in the summertime. Like the spray foam. Because it doesn't work well in the fucking winter.
No, and
just don't do fucking...
I done did it in my house one time, and I don't want to do it again.
Advice of the night. Don't fuck with spray foam in the fucking winter. It's a bad fucking life choice. I'm just saying.
What happens?
It doesn't set very well, and it's just a fucking dick.
I got you.
Like, just don't fucking do it. I'm just telling you now, don't. Fuck with spray foam in the winter. Anyway, so it'll be summertime. Well, you know, we'll spray foam a back wall, like an actual back to it. Something that has multiple levels for them to bask multiple places. And when I say them, most likely we'll probably, well,
eventually
we're going to look be like what the actual breeding is like entails with them, if it's really aggressive or not, because a lot of monitors have really aggressive breeding, and we don't want to have our female get hurt.
Yeah, I just can't. I can't do that. I can't do it.
But, I mean, if they are fairly chill, it's similar to, like, a gecko situation or something like that, I wouldn't care if we had a male and a female together. Otherwise, we'll have a couple of females together, probably.
Yeah.
So, I mean, yeah, we plan on having probably two. They are very social, and they like to have somebody else living
like
with
to
them.
This is one of the few reptiles that you actually should cohab, because they live in little colonies.
Right.
They're one of the very few social reptiles.
We gotta think there's a fuckload of bugs. So, like, they don't have to compete
they're
for
food.
They're
in Australia, where bugs is, like, their national bird. Okay, flies live there like a mofo.
Right.
Them bitches can just open their mouth and close it, I swear to God, and they get to fly.
But you know what I mean? They don't have to compete for food, like a lot of reptiles do.
Do you know that timber rattlesnakes are another one that live in colonies? They actually all have dens that they all go back to, and they're like a honeybee. They share where the best hunting grounds are, where there's to stay away from.
They leave, they have pheromones that they leave, so that way they can find their hunting spots again, actually.
That too, yep. And they use the same pheromones to communicate with each other, this stuff.
It's like how ants do.
It's really cool.
Yeah, I knew that, because generally, anytime that you see, like, a rattlesnake rescue thing, when they flip over a thing, or it's, you know, on a tarp, there's, like, four or five of these fuckers under one tarp.
Which diamondbacks aren't like that, but timber rattlesnakes are.
Which is what we have in northwestern Pennsylvania. Mostly in the mountains.
Yeah.
Generally, I mean, you hear about one every once in a while. Like, Tynesta, that golf course they have. They have a problem with having timbers. A couple of times a year, they see them on the actual golf course. Because it's in the middle of the fucking mountains.
Right.
So, like, yeah, it happens.
It does.
But most of the time, it's in the mountains. I know Kane, out in Kane, they have a big tournament, actually, to try to see which ones, the biggest ones you can catch. Which I believe they are all released afterwards back into the mountains.
I think what they do is they collect the venom from them to make the anti-venom is what they do with
Maybe
them,
that's
and then
what
they release them, I think is how they do that.
Maybe.
They make it fun for people to, and they make it beneficial as well. Like, you need that to get... make any of them.
I would honestly, I think it'd be really fun to go do sometime. And have
after
a couple
we
of,
learn how to...
A couple of nice-sized snake hooks and stuff, and these are, like, just rednecks that go out and fucking try to catch them. That, like... That's how it is. I'm like, oh, man. Like, these people don't even have a fucking idea. Like, they don't even fuck with snakes normally.
Right, and rattlesnakes have a very much so bigger strike range than most snakes.
They are more... I would say they're probably in the most dangerous of snakes as a whole.
They are.
Not deadly-wise, but dangerous for being... Most likely, you will be bit by one of them before you are most other stuff. Even though they usually have really nice temperaments as a whole. As long as you're not fucking with them too much, they won't fuck with you. The problem is when they do strike, they can strike literally two-thirds of their body length.
Most snakes, it's up to half of their body, and they are two-thirds.
And most of them are really less than that, though. Like, most of them don't strike more than, like, a quarter of their body. Most of them don't, like, generally.
My favorite is watching a retic do a full-on strike and watch it do half its body. Dude, that's a big strike, and it sucks. And I'm sure it's fucking terrifying.
Oh, yeah. The nice thing is it's a fairly slow strike compared to a lot of snakes. Like, it's so big that,
the
like, you see it coming.
The slower the strike.
Right, you see it coming.
Right.
Well, you say that, but, I mean, gaboons are, like, they're probably a solid damn near 6 feet. And, I mean, they're chonky as fuck.
They are chonky.
And they are, have
they're
a ridiculously
so
fast
cute. They're
strike.
Little buddies. Did you know what I learned the other day
oh,
about
Jesus.
Them? I learned that, to, you know how, like, copperheads, to attract prey, they wiggle their tail? Okay, so these guys actually wiggle their eyes, and they suspect they wiggle their little nose horns to get prey to come to them as a lure. But they have documented them using their eyes to lure prey to them.
Huh. I don't know if they can sit still in a spot and not move for, like,
a month.
Yeah, weeks. And I'm like, what the fuck?
They're ambush predators.
We've seen a couple in person, like, at, like,
we got to see them.
We went to a place on the way home from New York City, and the enclosure they had was a bioactive enclosure, and it was literally just sitting in the leaves in the bottom that you literally couldn't even see it.
Oh my god, it took us a minute to find it.
In my opinion, they had a wrong enclosure for it, but that was just
me. Enough cover, I guess.
Well, they had more of an arboreal setup. It was a
yeah, but it
tall...
was cohabbing with other stuff, too. And the stuff it was cohabbing with is arboreal.
But it was like a tall tank, and there wasn't a whole lot of ground space.
Right.
And it's a large ground snake. I mean,
I
they're chonky. They're
well,
fat,
we didn't
for
agree
sure.
with a lot of the housing choices in that place, but... You live, you know, we went and checked it out.
I really liked it as a whole. I mean, there was a lot of, like, different stuff there that we thought was really cool to see.
I liked a lot of the animals.
And, like, I liked they had a little parakeet,
Oh, God, the little birdhouse.
Birdhouse that literally, like, you'd walk in and you could buy popsicle sticks, but, I mean, if you go to them things, just look around, people get tired of feeding the birds and just leave the fucking sticks full of shit everywhere. So you just grab one of those sticks from somewhere and then you just fucking...
Yeah.
You don't have to pay, like, $3 for it, which I know. It does help the zoo, but at the same time, I bought shit at the gift shop, paid to get in, and blah, 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 you know, because we didn't just go there and not get in and get at the gift shop, we did get a couple of little things at the gift shop.
I got a monitor lizard that was this big, because the stuff in the gift shop was actually pretty pricey in there, it was, yeah.
It happens, but.
And we didn't want to pay the price that they wanted for a stuffy.
Well, it was like $23 or something
for
like that.
For one, it was like this big, and we're like, what the fuck?
Right, they can't see your hands.
No, I guess they can't.
A fairly small stuffed animal.
Like guinea pig size.
Yeah. Yeah, it was pretty expensive there. But it was pretty cool as a whole. I feel like when we do have our building and we do stuff like tourism and whatnot, it's never going to be like that. We'll have a lot of, like, because we'll be breeding, too. So we'll have, you know, a bunch of ball pythons, a bunch of carpet pythons, not just one or two. And, I mean, we'll have probably less species as a whole. I mean, we'll slowly just gain stuff.
But more variations within those species.
But we'll have more morphs and be able to teach about the genetics, too. I don't feel like barely anybody ever really talks about genetics. I mean, like, I've seen a couple of people that do, but most of them talk about, like, their localities. They talk about, like, their living, like, how the actual
how
animals
to care
live.
For them and whatnot.
But not really, like, the morphs that they have and different shit like that. You know what I mean?
Right. I know, you're going to be the one that's going to know everything there is to know about ball python morphs, and I'm going to be the one that knows everything there is to know about carpet python morphs.
Well, there's only 11 carpet python morphs or something like that. You know what I mean? Like,
Yeah, but I'm also not good at genetics. Like, I really have to work at it to understand them. And I'm still working at it, like, obviously.
Genetics is complicated if you don't have that kind of mindset.
I don't, and that's the problem. Right. So I really have to work at it to understand it.
And generally, for, like, that kind of, like, genetics, it's really interesting to me. And I really like it, so I do a lot of studying
on
it.
See, you'll be the one that can educate people on the genetics part of it. You know what I mean? Like, that'll be your powerhouse right there.
Right. But we plan on having a bunch of ball pythons and carpets eventually. And, like, different stuff that we breed. So, I mean, I don't know if we'll ever fully have, like, a full-on, like, reptile zoo. As much as, like, people can come check out stuff, have a good encounter. We would love to have, like, local schools come and check out stuff and, like, do tours and shit.
I can't wait to have people here and have room for bigger monitors. Like, I know we have a few different species we'd really like to get, and each requires a pretty decent size. So, like, I'm really excited to have those bigger ones to show people and teach people to be like, okay, guys, now here's... Because we're going to name the little guy Tinley. We're naming the Aki Tinley. Because that's where we're getting it. But... introduce him to Tinley and be like, alright, now watch this one. And all of a sudden, a big-ass, you know, water monitor comes out, or a tagoo, or... You know what I mean?
Right. Eventually, we will have different stuff like that. That's the reason why we're getting Tinley. Honestly, like...
We can introduce monitors to them, at least to some degree.
So, we have some snakes, we have some lizards, we don't have anything that's in the realm of geckos right now, which we plan to get here once we get our income tax, which is here in the next couple months.
Yeah.
And then we also plan on, and the other end of reptiles that we haven't touched yet, that's a big one, is monitors. And we haven't, like, we haven't even gotten close to thinking about monitors, honestly.
No,
to actually, like, own a monitor. We love looking at them and hanging out with them, but...
Most monitors require such a large space, and we can't provide that right now, so we can't.
I mean, most monitors are at least 3 feet, if not bigger.
Minimum.
Even
most
that,
of the ones we want are, like, 6 to 8 feet.
Even that blue monitor we were looking at with a really pretty look to it, it's 32 to 38 inches.
Yeah.
I mean, so, I mean, it's 3 feet head to tail, which it has a long tail, but granted. But, I mean, still,
it
needs space for that.
It's a decent sized monitor, and it's an arboreal monitor, so, like, it needs a tall space.
Right.
Like, so we have to be smart. Like, same reason we don't have a retic or a berm right now. Literally don't have the room for them.
I would absolutely love to have a gorgeous granite albino berm. Like, I would love to have a granite albino berm. They're just fucking stellar looking.
I want to be able to just hang out with my berm on the couch, all snuggled up.
But my problem with that is I don't have a fucking space in my house for a berm.
No,
and, like, we will never have a house big enough to be able to house a berm in our house. We won't.
No.
We won't. We have a small house. We plan on adding room to our house, but, like, nothing like that.
No.
No.
That'll be building out back with our other ones. You know, like, they'll have their own little bedroom, basically, over there. Because that's what they need, is a fucking bedroom.
Remind me, the place that we got the mailbox. So, or I was going to say that, but we could just put it that way. So I was going to, like, talk to you about, like, what it's called and whatnot, and we don't need to do that on the podcast. But anyways, so the place we got the mailbox... That's how I want to set up our building. Like, we have... So, like, imagine our 60 by 100 is, like, the main building for it. Okay? And then there's that, like, little room in there that has extra... And, like, they bought that whole plaza. And just kind of kept adding on. That's what I would like to do with our building. Is just, like, have the building, like... Right where we talked about it, you know... Whether it goes this way or this way, whichever way they actually can do it. And then build on another building, or something like that, that kind of situation. And then, like, we'll have, like, our mythical creature garden in the middle of it, however we end up building it. So, like, I think that's, like, how I want to do it. So they're all attached. And then, you know, oh, this is our ball python room. And then it just has a fuckload of ball pythons in that room. And, you know.
And then a carpet python room.
And then eventually we'll have a carpet room, I'm sure of it.
It's going to be my favorite room in the entire building. I'm sure of it.
But, like, that's how I'd like to eventually do it. And then once we have that, like, like our, I'm sure eventually, once we do build on a building just for balls, we'll take, instead of just having the main portion of the building, that's where we'll put all of our different species and stuff, like, for people. And then we'll have specialty rooms that, and once we build on, will be the specialty rooms.
Right.
That's my thought process. And then, like I said, upstairs, I would like to have a big spiral staircase to go upstairs, and then upstairs, we have, like, a big incubation center, and then, like, probably, like, all of our food center.
Right.
In the main building.
Right.
You know, I just think that would be cool for people to see that whole aspect, too.
I think that'd be a good idea.
I think it would be pretty cool. And then, like, once we're to that point, once we have a bunch of space, in my opinion, then we could use the garage for, like, a quarantine room.
A hospital room, a quarantine room.
That's my thought process.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, and then also, like, we could also use that for an incubation room also. Just have, because the incubators, I mean, they look like little mini fridges, really what they look like.
Right.
The bigger ones. And, I mean, we're going to have a lot of shit eventually that we're breeding. So, I'm sure we'll have a couple of nice, like, a room-size incubator, but you never know. We might have something special that needs to be in an incubator around.
Nerd has a room-size incubator, plus, like, 4 more in the basement, and last year they ran out of room, and Kevin had to incubate a whole bunch at his house, and then they had to incubate a whole bunch at an employee's house, because they just ran out of fucking room.
Right. But
that's crazy.
He breeds everything, though.
He does. That's he has a lot of stuff he works with. The one thing we haven't said anything about that, like, gotten into, because, like, you listed off the snakes and the lizards and the monitors, is crocodilians, and that'll be a hot, hot, hot fucking minute before we
The problem with crocodilians is you literally have to have an entire room for it. Like,
depending on, like, even a caiman requires a large area.
The problem with most all crocodilians is you need to have a pond for them.
Yeah, not
no matter what, and you can't just do that shit with an enclosure.
No, you, it's...
Well, okay, so, like, Ivy and Aries, right?
Ariana.
That's an enclosure that has a pond, but there's a lot of fucking work to that bullshit.
You know how much that enclosure cost him?
Oh, I don't even want to know.
Yeah, you do. $32,000.
Yeah, that's not a shocker.
Like...
Yeah.
Basically, what they need is an in-ground swimming pool with slopes until it gets nice and deep and have lots of land to hang out on. Like, that's what they fucking need.
Right. And that's just not feasible.
No, not right now, it's not.
But, it won't be feasible for a good minute to have a proper enclosure for them. So most people, like, a lot of people...
Well, you started
honestly,
in tubs,
I feel like a lot of people usually don't give most reptiles the kind of space that they usually need.
As a whole, yes, but it's because right now the reptile industry is going through a very rapid learning experience, and we're learning that these animals need way more than what we've been giving them, and right. So now everybody's slowly learning and evolving how they keep these animals, you know what I mean?
Right. I know.
It's a process.
So, as, like, how we are as people, we want to give them as much space as we can give them at the same time as what's going to be feasible for our ability to do for what we have, what we're going to have.
Like, obviously, every carpet python can't have a whole bedroom. They don't need a whole bedroom. But they definitely need a large enclosure.
Yeah. I mean, a 4x4x2 is a pretty nice-sized enclosure.
It is a nice-sized enclosure. Yeah. And, I mean, if Mocha ever does hit 12 feet, she's going to need bigger than that. But that's not for anytime soon. You know what
right.
I mean? Like, she's not going to be that big until she's, like, 10, 12 years old. You know what I mean?
Right.
So, like, I'm not worried about it.
Right. We'll get to that point eventually.
When time comes and she needs it, she'll get it. We'll make sure she does. Everybody will have what they need.
Right. Can you imagine Mocha at 12 feet in a tree that we built or something?
Oh my god.
She'd be so fucking just creepy. She's gonna be creepy when she's that big. Like, and just like stare at you like...
Thinking about it right now makes me worry about trying to get her out of said tree. I'm like...
Or feeding.
Oh, god. That's why we're target training her as we speak. Like, she is learning that because that girl, if she is the way she is now when she's real big, we're going to have a problem. Feeding her is going to be a hassle. Mm-hmm. So, like, we have to correct this issue now while she's still at a manageable size.
Well, the problem with, like, babies and stuff is if you try to train them too early, I don't know if it's going to, like, I don't know.
Like... It depends.
Like, I feel like her almost being a year old is a really good time to start training her.
Yeah, I feel like you need to worry more about socializing them first and getting them to understand that you are not here to hurt them.
And then, once you have a rapport,
then
they'll train better.
Then after that, you have to start getting them to understand that you do not mean food. Or, depending on what the animal is, you are not food.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
And you have to disassociate that for them. Especially when you have ones that have a high, like, food response. Mocha has a ridiculous food response.
Oh, no.
I fed her a small rat. Oh, I guess it was a weanling rat. Fed her a weanling rat. And I had to feed a couple other ones, like, 3 days later. Because it wasn't their time to eat yet. That bitch was waiting for hers. I'm like, you still have a lump in your gut from your rat. You do not need another one. And she most certainly thinks she does. She would eat 2 or 3 times a week if I let her.
Well, it's just like Layla. She's the same way. She's like, it's been 2 days, I'm ready for more. I'm like, no.
I'm like, Layla, you have had an appropriate size meal for your size. You do not need more.
Well, Tear Bear. So, she actually, I think it's really, really cool, actually.
It makes me giggle.
She literally perches on this branch that she has, this piece of driftwood. Like she's waiting for something to run underneath it.
Yep. She
like
coils
for her,
around it.
For her to actually like strike and actually like she would in the wild.
Yeah.
And like none of our other ones do that. They just lay in a ball somewhere and then like when food comes, they're like, "Yes, please." That's what Mocha does. Like as soon as you like open her door, she's like, "Food."
Oh, yeah.
And she just sits in her ball. She doesn't like. Terry's the only one that sits, like, in actual, like, hunting position and waits for it.
She literally coils around her back half, like, her hat, last half around that log. And then she just hangs in an S across the rest of them, just lays there and watches the ground and waits for something to run by. I'm like, bitch, nothing's gonna run by. I've never even put a live rat in there with you, ever. I have always fed her frozen thawed. I don't know if she ever had live before us, but... She has not had live since she's been here, and in May, it'll be a year. So,
And she's grown over 2 feet with us.
She's grown so much.
So, I mean, she's doubled her size at least since she was with us. So, like, she couldn't have been very old when we got her, for sure.
I fed her a small rat, and then a week later, I fed her a small rat again because she was hunting already. She's in there right now. Do you want to know what she was doing today after I just fed her Monday? Mm. Sitting in her something's going to run across this path pose.
Yeah, I saw it earlier.
I'm like, girl.
She makes me laugh.
Ugh. I love her. She's my favorite, but Jesus. She makes me giggle. I think she is my broken snake. She really is. And I don't care.
Her and Charlie.
Yeah, Charlie's our little broken snake, too. And then Chance is our little anxiety snake.
I mean, all of them have their own personalities as a whole.
They
really do. Like, a lot of people are like, it's a snake. I'm like, yeah, a snake that has its own personality. Like, no shit, Edgar's the only one that does it. Like, as a whole, the way he does it. But when you hang out with him, you put him back in there, he gets, like, coiled up just right. He can just stare at you.
He does.
Whether it's in his house or, like, the edge of his glass, and he just stares at you like, excuse me, you put me away. And, like... is upset that you put him away. That's what he acts like. Like, he's begging to come back out. And I'm like, I just had you out. And he's like, but I want to come out, Dad. I'm like, no.
oh my god, one of my favorite things is that Marvels crawls on top of his hide now and watches TV. He watches the movies the kids are watching.
It's just like we were talking about Cheese today, too. Cheese likes to just, she is perfect sight to TV right in front of her. She's in our dining room, actually, and our straight ahead is our living room. We have like a, it's all open layout.
Yeah.
And we have, you know, a 50-inch TV. So it's a decent size. So, like, she sits there and waits for the TV to get turned on. She just sits, she has a, like a crocheted bed that she just sits on, and she sits there and just watches TV.
She does. She turns her head just enough she can see with her eye, and she watches TV. All day. That's what she does. Sometimes she goes in her house, takes a nap. Once in a while you hear her make a lap or two around there. Nothing crazy. She just kind of goes and checks over everything, and then she goes back to watching TV for a little bit. I'm like, you little psycho.
They all have their own little things about them.
They do.
Speaking of little things and whatnot, so we have some stuff to go over here.
Yeah, we didn't go over anything the first time.
Yeah, yeah. So, speaking of little things, how about we talk about a strain of weed?
All right, let's do that.
I know, we've been on the reptiles topic for a while. I'm like, all right, we got to get our stuff out, too.
I'm sorry.
Like our normal stuff. It's okay. It's been good. It's been good. It's the manifestation.
It is. Manifest, guys. Manifest. It's real.
So, it really is. If you really believe in it. Anyways, stop it. We're going to talk about a strain called Lennon tonight.
Lennon?
Lennon.
Like the dude?
Like John Lennon.
Okay.
So, Lennon, you could buy seeds for Lennon by Pyramid Seeds. Which is in Barcelona, I guess. That's what it says, at least.
Wait, like, our Barcelona?
No.
Oh.
Jesus, the country Barcelona.
Oh, there's a country?
Yeah, oh my fuck. It's South America.
Okay.
Anyways, Lennon is a sativa dominant, being 80% sativa. Its parents is pure haze, so, like, an actual just haze plant, and Jack Herer.
Yes.
So, like, you know it's got to be pretty fucking good.
That sounds great.
Like, one's a legendary, like, Hayes was one of the originals back in, like, the 60s that was, like, really dope, okay? And then Jack Herer has been around since the mid-70s, and, like, we had Jack Herer last year, and let me tell you what, I've never been that kind of high in my life.
Dude,
that's the only strain I've ever been that kind of high in my life.
That's literally my favorite strain of weed to tattoo on.
Like, you're just so relaxed, and, like, there's, like, your mind is just set, like, free, nothing's going on.
No, I can literally zone into the tattoo I'm doing and be 1,000% focused on it. Sometimes when I'm like that, though, I forget to talk to the client.
Right? So, yeah, I was like, wow.
Yeah.
That's gotta be pretty good. Believe it or not, the THC on it's only 19%, so that's actually kind of low. They could be all the way up to almost 30. So, I mean, 19 is kind of low. There is some CBD on there. It's a 0.5%.
Oh, so a whole lot.
Its spice, or its smell and flavor is citrus, fresh, and spicy.
So it smells very weedish.
Everyone, I don't know. Like, I've never, like, smelt a piney smell from...
Oh, I have.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't get it.
I've never smelled a spicy smell is my thing. Like, what the fuck is a spicy smell?
Like, does it smell like hot pepper seeds
or
something?
Right,
or like,
does it mean it's just a really strong odor? Like, I don't know.
Right, so the effect is a body buzz, euphoric, long-lasting, and relaxed. Which speaks a lot about Jack here, too, honestly. Like, so I honestly see that coming. So, there's no reviews on it, actually. It says, Lennon, the weed John Lennon would have smoked. Lennon is an exceptional cross of Jack Herer with pure haze. The result is a super strong sativa hybrid, 80% sativa, that is very psychoactive effect. This strain will make your body feel heavy and give you some dizziness at times, actually. The taste is citrusy and reminiscent of lime, while the aroma resembles incense.
Maybe that's what it means by spicy.
Maybe. Lennon has a THC of level of 19%. Due to haze genetics, the buds aren't very dense, but the plant still puts out a nice harvest of 500 grams per metric meter. under a 600 watt light at that indoors. This strain grows to a height of 90 to 180 centimeters. So probably about 4 feet tall is all.
Okay.
Not super tall. I think it's about 4 feet tall. The flower is 80 days. So it literally grows for just under 3 months.
Like 2.5 months-ish.
Yeah. Under natural sunlight, it produces 0.5 to 1.5 kilograms per plant. Which I'm not sure exactly how many, like, so I think that's 1,000 kilograms, or 1,000 grams is a kilogram.
A non-American wrote this, didn't they?
I'm sure of it.
Because we're the only idiots who don't use this system.
I'm sure of it. I mean, being that it says that it's from Barcelona, I mean...
Right.
I figure. But anyways, if that puts anything into perspective, 1 kilogram is 1,000 grams, okay? There's 29.5 grams in 1 ounce.
Tell me how... 29.5 grams and 16 ounces in a pound.
So, it would be... I mean, for a small plant at 0.5 grams, it'd be 500 grams. It would be... Every 100 would be about an ounce.
200 and something.
Every 100 would be 4 ounces. So it's about, I mean, it's about a pound for outside. I mean, that's pretty good. For that's on a small side, up to 3 pounds.
I got you.
That's also wet, too. After dry, you're going to lose about 40%.
I got you.
So, I mean, you know, 25 to 40%. The plant is ready for harvest in early November. I was like, wow, that's a late one. They're usually, October is the later ones, usually.
Right.
The plant is somewhat nutrient sensitive, so it's recommended to use substrates that are very low in nitrogen and not pre-fertilized. It's very difficult to grow.
Oh, so we don't
like
want
for it to thrive.
I got you.
It's got a photo period. It's 11 to 12 weeks. Early November is the outside. The yield indoors is about 500 grams per metric meter, which is a 3 foot space, by the way, on an average.
I have a silly question.
What?
Okay, so harvest would be like November-ish.
Yeah.
Here, we usually have snow in November. Like, can you grow them outside here? Or is it too cold and you have to grow it inside?
I mean, I'm imagining you'd probably want to grow it inside.
I was just curious how that worked.
I'm imagining you would, or else you would just do it at the wrong time of year for here.
Right.
I mean, it doesn't get very warm here either. And I mean, if it's from South America, where there's a lot of, like, water, because it's, yeah. I mean, there's a lot of, like, rain there. So, I don't know. It says that it grows pretty tall for the size of the actual plant itself.
Okay.
And you can get them from Pyramid Seeds in Barcelona. There you go.
Very good.
Yeah. I was like, Lennon. I was like, let's see what Lennon's about. Like, right. I'm a music fanatic. So, like, I was like, all right, I'm guessing it's going to be named after John Lennon for some reason, whether he helped start it or whatever. So they're just saying that's the kind of high that he would like.
Right.
Or else that he did like when he was alive.
Right.
So he would be smoking that probably.
I got ya. Very cool.
It was interesting.
Right?
So we need to...
Let's start with...
We're a third of the way done with this half, and we haven't even started smoking our second pipe out of three. This pipe will only take us 5 minutes to smoke, though. Well, that's new. Not to mention you have to, like, try to suck start a fucking Harley the way you suck things. Like, I'm like, stop it. Chill out.
Know how to be any other way, okay?
You're funny. Alright, so, are you ready? We did do one section in the first, or one thing in the first section. We went over the advice tonight.
Yeah, we did.
Okay. God damn it. What the fuck? Oh, okay. What is a flop era?
Flop era?
Yep, flop era.
I think it's a period, an era where nothing fucking happens. Like, nothing exciting, it's super boring, and dumb.
Okay. I gotcha. A word that describes your life when it's falling apart. So, I wouldn't say that necessarily you were close, because it's different, but, like, it's
kinda,
like,
but
this
not.
A shitty part in your life, a shitty time in your life, more or less, rather than just a boring time. And it says, the example is, hey, your whole family died in a car crash, and you failed your finals. How are you feeling? Oh, it's okay. I'm just in my flop era right now.
I'm fairly certain that's not the reaction anybody would be looking for at that sentence, but sure!
For sure, you, I don't know.
I'd be like, my what? And lose my shit.
Well, I'm sure this was like, they knew.
Maybe.
And they were just like, you know, how are you right now? Like, they're just saying maybe. What happened in that time, and they're like, how are you all right? Like, how are you doing? And they're like, just living in a flop era. Like, it's just shit, more or less.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, makes sense.
Yeah, you just have to look at it into the context of how it would be laid out. Like, it's just telling you what's going on in their life. And then they're asking it, and that's the answer.
See, this is why I have you. You have to break stuff down for me, because I'm dumb.
It doesn't say any of that by looking at it. It's just, that's what they're, like, building up to.
I know,
and how
but you're smarter than me, and you're able to imply that.
I don't know if it's necessarily that I'm smarter than you. It's just that I understand things differently than you.
Maybe, but you're still smarter than me. You know way more shit about way more stuff. I know shit about animals and how to do artwork, and that's about the extent of it. Oh, and how to keep kids alive. Not plants, but kids.
Animals. Animals as a whole. Kids are animals, trust me.
Sure,
ours are savages.
They're but animals you don't eat.
Anyone that likes crudes out there, just saying. So, what's your questions? We did the entire show backwards today.
Yeah, we fucking did. Okay. If you had to get rid of one of your five senses, sight, touch, sound, taste, or feeling, which would you choose?
Smell. I don't smell anything as it is, so it wouldn't take anything away from me that I don't already have. Let's be honest here. I mean, a really strong smelling weed I can smell. Otherwise, like, I don't smell a dick. You're like, wait a minute. Smell wasn't one of the five senses, was it?
No. Sight, touch, sound, taste, and feeling. Isn't feeling touch?
Yeah, feeling is touch.
They listed twice. Okay, we're going to replace one of those with smell.
Smell. Yeah, smell, stupid. Though. Smell or hearing, because let's be honest, I don't hear for shit anyways.
I don't want to replace my hearing. I like being able to hear what I do get to hear. But I'm,
well, yeah, because music, yeah.
I'm
yeah.
with you on the smell thing.
I couldn't lose my sense of taste for good, because let's be honest.
You were miserable!
It fucking drove me nuts not being able to taste anything for 2 weeks, okay? Like, fucking stupid.
And I like being able to touch stuff. I have a thing for textures. So, like, I like being able to touch things.
Right?
And let's see.
My sight is the only thing that really does work on me, so, like, I couldn't get rid of my sight.
Guys, my sight is incredibly important for what I do, okay? Like,
right.
I kind of need my sight. You can be a tattoo artist with a lot of different disabilities, but a blind one is probably not one.
I mean, I don't think you're 100% wrong there.
I mean, that would be my fair guess. I don't want to say it's impossible, because then somebody will prove me wrong, but, like, it is incredibly improbable.
Yeah, yeah.
That type of thing. But, yeah. Like, my smell, I wouldn't have to smell your nasty-ass rat farts anymore. I wouldn't have to smell the fucking dog farts. Yeah, they smell like a fucking rat crawled up your ass and died.
Jesus. I was like, what the fuck is a rat fart?
I wouldn't have to smell our stinky-ass kids' breath when they come give me a hug in the morning, because their breath reeks.
Yeah,
every time Autumn takes a shit in her litter box, I would have to smell
horrible.
That no more.
You smell it for like an hour. You're like, ugh. Whole house smells like shit.
Because
literally.
She just got a fragrant poop.
But yeah, I would just get rid of my sense of smell.
Yeah.
I don't really have one for most of the majority of things.
I think there are a few things I would miss the smell of. Like grounds.
Well, like, today our house smells delightful. It really does.
Our house does?
Yeah.
Oh, it's probably because of what I made for dinner.
Those pork chops. Like, it has a really garlicky aroma, and then something else that's really sweet in there, too.
Maple syrup.
You put some maple syrup in it?
The boy requested it.
Anyways, it smells delicious. Like, I got home and I was like, oh man, that smells good. I'm like, I'm kind of hungry.
Did you eat one?
Yeah.
Okay. Did you like them? Were they good?
Yeah.
I couldn't remember if you just had the mac and cheese or if you ate that too.
No. I'm a carnivore. Like, well, I guess in all essence, in real honesty, I'm an omnivore. But still, like,
I'm a junk food holic.
Meat's a thing.
Because I want cookies and milk when I go in. That's my
thing. I want cookies and milk, too.
Milk cup.
MILF.
Oh, man.
I'm just saying. Like, if you're going to emphasize it, I'll emphasize mine, too.
You had some milk. Now it's time for some milk.
No. No, that was just... That was like... having fast food, and then I still am going to have dinner later.
Fairly certain he just called it a snack.
And dinner, see? In the same sentence!
Oh, so now I'm not sure if I should be offended that I'm big enough for both, or not.
Get the fuck out of here.
I know. You're fine.
Right now, you're literally the smallest woman I've been with in, like... At least 10 years, probably.
Well, considering we've been together for 6.5 years, almost.
I mean, 10 years, probably.
That's not that much longer.
Because, like, I dated a few people between, like, my first wife and you. And, like, you're definitely smaller than any of them.
Right, your first wife was...
And my first wife was pretty small when we first got together, but, like...
Everything I lost...
I would say you're about, like, the same size that she was when we first got together, besides the fact that... You have bigger than A cup boobs, and she had more ass than you do, but you have bigger boobs than she did. Otherwise, I feel like I feel like as a whole, it's just
roughly the same.
You're about the same size and shape, because she was 5'9" as well. I don't know. I've never been into bigger women,
no,
but like taller women. But both of my ex wife and my wife.
You
want to
know why?
Tall.
She was my replacement until I could come around. That's how that worked. She was a poor substitute. That's why it didn't work.
You're funny. What's your other question?
Okay, would you rather be a worried genius or a joyful simpleton?
I mean, I feel like I'm a joyous simpleton in all reality, in real life. But
see, I feel like I'm a worried simpleton all the time. Because I stress out over stuff all the time. So I'm like, well, that kind of sucks, because I'm worried and stupid.
I got both the negatives. What the fuck?
But I'm also kind of funny. So, like, am I a worried, joyful simpleton? Because there ain't no fucking way I'm a genius.
I mean, like, you're definitely smart in your own things. Like, you... experiment in tattooing, just like you're like, I think this is gonna work. I've worked it out in my head. I think it's gonna work. And then it turns out, you know,
right?
It works. Like, you know what you're talking about, even though you don't know what you're talking about. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
right.
You just, you're like, this is gonna work. It's gonna work. I know it's gonna work. And then it works.
I'm always worried about if I ever have to ever decide to try and teach somebody how to do a tattoo, because I don't always know how I do what I do. How do you do that?
You don't explain things well.
No, I don't.
And it's kind of like how I am. Like, I actually almost failed a math class when I was in school. It was my lowest grade I ever had in high school. Yes, it's raining. Anyways, so, it was the lowest grade I ever had in high school, actually. I got, 78 in it. And in our area, you have to have a 75 in order to be an actual passing grade.
Yeah.
So... Because a D is not actually considered passing. It's weird.
No, it's not.
So, I got a 78 in it. On every test, I got like 40%. That's it. Because you had to show your work, you had to get the answer right, and you had to do it the way that he taught you. And to get the full actual points for all your stuff in your test. I never did any of that. I literally wrote the answer down, that's all. So I always had the right answer, and that was it.
What baffles me is they put me in advanced chemistry, okay? My average for the year, at the end of the year, was a 98%. there was one quarter, I finished the quarter with 104%. I was really good at chemistry. And then they put me in advanced economics. Oh my god!
Okay. You can't even do normal economics. Why the fuck would they put
you
in advanced?
They put me in advanced I had to study for like 2 to 3 hours every single night, and I passed by the skin of my teeth. I was literally like, I can't comprehend this. Like, I literally don't understand, and I'm trying so hard. And he knew I was trying, because I would stay and talk to him and ask him to explain something better to me. And I tried so hard. I passed that class, like, with a, I think it was like a 76 is what I passed with. They let me out of it. They didn't make me do it again. I barely passed that fucking class.
Right.
It was fucking atrocious. They decided that was enough of the advanced classes in that department. They let me keep the advanced, like, science-y shit, but not that stuff.
What I would really like to do, going back to, like, talking about genes a little bit.
I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. Like, we've been jumping around everywhere. We're trying to get our sections done, different stuff. We've been jumping around. But going back to genes, I would love to go in to, like, high schools, and if they have molecular science, or, you know what I mean, anything like that.
Right.
Molecular biology and shit like that. I would love to go in and teach about genes. Mm-hmm. Because that's usually when you actually learn extensively in genes, is usually in... like a molecular biology or advanced biology.
Would I like biology?
It's more or less just about like
it's the study living of
things.
Living.
Yeah, living things.
I had a terrible biology teacher.
I had a wonderful teacher in biology. I
learned
her.
More about how to make different desserts than I did actual biology, and I failed literally every single test. I did all my homework, and that's the only reason I passed that class.
Yeah. I had a lady named Mrs. Razy. She retired the year I was in ninth grade, and I took two biology classes. Because what I was doing was doing all my sciences, and like try to get all my sciences done just in the first 2 years of high school. And I did all my math in the first 2 years of high school, and I only had to have two English classes, so I took one each year. And then my junior and senior year, I fucked off. Like, I did all my hard classes in 9th and 10th grade year.
Okay,
so
I
like,
get it.
When I took molecular biology, I was the only 9th grader in the class. I took it before regular biology, because that's the only class I could get into for it. And they were like, you still have to have one more, because you had to have, in 9th grade, you had to have earth science, and then you had to have another, I took an extra one instead of taking, like, a bullshit class. I took a science class, so that way I didn't have to in my last 2 years. And I took in molecular biology. And then in 10th grade, I took biology and then chemistry. Because that's the...
Right.
You have to have a chemistry class, a biology class, an earth science class, and you can have... You're supposed to have a fourth one for it. They had, like, physics, which I took physics, too.
I didn't get to do physics. I elected to do a second health class because I was in the medical field over physics.
The physics I used as a math class and not a science class.
I got you.
Because which it was a fifth science that I took, but it was
they
considered
thought I
would
do well
too.
In physics because I did well in chemistry. But I looked at some people's physics homework and I was like,
a lot of it. There's a lot of math, so it's like a mathematical science.
Yeah,
but
see,
it's, like, there's a lot of, like, there's a lot of science in it, too. It's just, like, a lot of it's, like, momentum and different shit like
yeah,
that
see,
is what it's about.
I don't
about.
Think I would have been as good at that, because I really do suck at
math. I'm really good at math, and I really like science. So, like, physics, and I have Mr. Zarger, and that dude was just super awesome. He was a super awesome teacher. He never let anybody fall behind, and was, like, really good at, like, explaining shit really easily to people. And, like I had really dumb people in my class, actually. And, like, they all did really good. And it was physics. Physics is not an easy class as a whole.
Right.
But, yeah, so in my ninth grade year, I took molecular biology. I was the only person that was not a junior or senior. Yeah, and I had one of the highest grades in the class.
That's awesome.
And then she retired that year. Mrs. Lazy did. So I only got to have her one time. And she was super awesome. She was, like, really good at, like, just explaining stuff and, like, everything that you did in there. Like, It was, she had made everything, like, kind of fun.
Right.
I really liked her class a lot when I didn't end up having her.
My senior year, I had most of my stuff done. And so, I didn't need to take a math. And I took, so I ended up taking two health classes instead. And I ended up for the year with two study halls, one in the morning. The first class in the morning was a study hall. So, you know, nap time. And my second to last class of the day was study hall. My last class was art. So, like, it was wonderful.
Right. I actually had the ability to graduate early, a semester early, but I didn't.
No?
No, I wanted to graduate with everyone else, because if you graduated early, you didn't walk at the end of the year.
Oh, that's stupid.
No, because you already had your diploma and everything. So you didn't actually walk at the end of the year, and I was like, no, I'm not doing that. So I literally, my junior year, I took regular photography. I took a CAD class, which is computer aided drafting.
Got ya.
Which drafting is like engineering stuff. I did like the Junior Engineering Technical Society stuff. It was called JETS. That was a big like competition with math and science and stuff. I did that every year.
This and, is what like, I'm talking about. You're way smarter than I am.
But like it's just like literally in math and science. I'm fucking retarded when it comes to like English and shit. Like I. Like, when the boy's like, what's a proverb? I'm like, or, like...
Pronoun.
A pronoun, yeah, exactly. Like, get the fuck out of here. So, like, a pronoun, or what's the other one there? I don't know, it starts with a P, I don't know. But, he'll be like, what's a pronoun? I'm like, it's part of a word at the beginning of a noun. And they're like, he's like, I don't think that's quite right. I'm like, probably not. I'm like, if you want help with math or science, like you need chemistry help, I can help you with that. You want math help? I can do that. Don't ask me about English. I'm stupid. Like,
oh, I know.
And I can't spell fucking shit. Like this, no. Like today, what was it? License. I cannot spell license. It doesn't matter how many times I try to spell license.
Oh,
I always fuck it up.
Yeah, but I can't do fucking English and shit either. He'll be like, Mom, how do you spell this? And I'm like, hey, Google, how do you spell this? Because I have no idea.
I love how you looked at your phone, you're like waiting for it, you're like, okay, you're good. But, I took CAD, which most people don't want to do CAD. I thought it was really fun, actually. But, like, I took photography, I took cabinet making, like, I took a bunch of just fuck off all day. Just, I really enjoyed my high school. Like, everyone's, like, stressing out and, like, worrying about stuff. I was just having fun playing with shit in every class.
That's because you put in the work early.
Well, I really like science and stuff. So, in English, like, you do a lot of English stuff in junior high in Corey. So, like, where we're from. So, like, from 7th and 8th grade, you have, like, 3 English classes each year. You're like... Why?
Stupid.
So then when you get
I remember.
So then when you get to high school, then you have one math class for every year and one science class for every year and then 2 English classes. And then that's all you need to have
when
to graduate.
When I was in middle school, they put me in applied math cuz I was bad at math. Right. And then for some reason they just kept by high school they had me in the advanced math class. I had me in advanced trigonometry my sophomore year. I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with you people?
Trig is very hard.
I really had to really work liked, at it. I did really well liked. In there. I did well in it, but I really had to work at it.
I really liked well. Trig, actually. I was really good at trig back then. I couldn't do it now. I haven't done it in
I was better at trig years. Than I was at geometry. I was...
Geometry is stupid easy.
I hated geometry.
Stupid Ugh. Fucking easy.
I hated it.
Stupid easy.
Oh my god, I had to work hard. In school to do well. And I didn't even, like, do great. I graduated, like, mid-pack, and that was me working my ass off, okay?
Out of 185 students who graduated, I was 26. And a lot of my people I graduated with are doctors, lawyers, teachers.
Yeah,
like,
no.
I graduated with a really smart class, actually. It was actually, I was really proud of myself. One time, so we did Sudokus mm-hmm. for a contest thing one day in our homeroom. And I beat the valedictorian of our class that was like, he's a doctor. Like, he's a doctor now. So, like, yeah.
We had, my graduating class had 208 students.
Mine had 210 before they all fucking quit school.
And then I graduated at 102. Like, that's where my, so I literally came in at middle of the pack, busting my ass, trying to do decent.
Yeah, I had fun just fucking off my last 2 years of school. But yeah, you could do, like, physics could be either a math or a science because there's both highly in it. So I used that as a math class.
Right.
I was like, fuck yeah. I had literally three science classes at one point in time. I had earth science, molecular biology, and physics in one shot.
I fucking hated earth science. It was so goddamn boring.
Ours, we only took a test every four chapters. You know how much of a bitch it was trying to remember three chapters ago? You're like, okay.
Yeah, no. And the teacher never pronounced my name right. Not one time. The entire school year.
My teacher I had was a pervert.
Oh, that's fun.
The girl that sat next to me used to write the answers to the test up her legs and would wear a really tiny skirt. So then she'd pull up her skirt and she'd like, I'd be like, oh, I'm gonna look at your legs too. Cause I'm like, fuck yeah. I'm like, literally, are you gonna like catch us for cheating when you're literally staring straight up a girl's skirt?
Right.
And we were the first table in front of his desk. I was like, fuck it. Like, I know that he caught us cheating, but at the same time, like, is he really gonna be like, can't, like, cause literally,
lift
like,
lift up your skirt.
Well, like, he's, like, first off, he would know about it, yeah, sure, but, like, it's evident you're staring straight into her fucking situation there.
Right.
Like, to see that, like, so, like, you gonna give yourself away?
Right.
This guy was smarter than that.
Well, at least he was smarter. I mean, I don't know.
That's how I passed his test, because, holy fuck, dude.
I did fine in earth science, like, I passed my test, did my homework. I just found it incredibly boring, so focusing on it was really hard.
Well, like, earth science is kind of like putting it with geology. It, like, geology and, what is it? Social studies. Because, like, it talks about, like, different continents and, like, stuff that's in social studies, too.
Yeah, geography. Not something I'm good at. Not even a little bit. Social studies. Listen, I can tell you some really fun facts about some events, okay? Like, some historical events. I'll know this random fact or that. However, do not ask me what year they happened. Like, I'm not gonna fucking know. Okay?
Right. I don't blame you.
I have no idea. Well, what year did the Civil War happen? I don't fucking know. A long-ass time ago.
Down in a town called Kickapoo.
No! Do not Jack Black me!
I can't help it, okay? You were just missing fucking, but still, like, oh, it was too good not to. It really is. Come on. You can't knock on Kickapoo.
Okay? I sure fucking can't.
No, you can't.
Yeah, I can't.
Enough.
No.
It's so good.
Dumb. I don't like it.
You have a prejudice against him, okay? Shut up.
I find him to be literally the most obnoxious human being on the planet.
Which, by the way, I want to listen to him doing the national anthem, just because. He's actually a really good singer when he actually sings.
It piqued my interest just a little bit when your mom was talking about it.
Yeah, so when the Super Bowl was going on, my mom was bragging about how Jack Black does a beautiful rendition of the
National anthem.
Sorry.
That's okay. Which, if he put, like, isn't trying to be his silly, wacky self and sound ridiculous, I would intrigue to see. You know what I mean?
Like, he's a really good singer as a whole. But I know you're not a fan of him.
No hate on you guys that love him. I know, like, 98% of people love him. I'm not saying he's not talented. He's very skilled. I literally just find him incredibly obnoxious.
The funny thing is I really like Jack Black as a whole. But, like, what he's, one of the biggest things he's known for is, you know, Tenacious D. That movie, I cannot stand that movie. It's like Sausage Party. It's just ridiculous, and, like, I don't...
It's stupid. Nacho Libre is right up there with him.
That one, I'm not a big fan of Nacho Libre either.
I literally watched that movie and went, I literally just wasted, like, 2 hours of my entire life, and it was stupid.
Right. But, like, I really love School Rock.
I like the message behind School of Rock. I really do. Like, it's a cute movie.
The new Jumanji movies is they're I like them. They're both really good.
I'll give it to you. I enjoyed Jack Black in the new Jumanji movies, but he's also not being Jack Black in those movies either.
He is being very much Jack Black still. Just saying. I haven't really watched Gulliver's Travels too much. All I could think of is Hal.
Shallow Hal.
Dumb
movie.
I mean, there is some funny parts in the movie. There is quite a few funny parts, but at the same time, I'm not huge on it, the actual movie itself.
I'm not at all.
Not for a Jack Black film.
I'm just not a fan as a whole. And right? I'm sorry if that hurts anybody's feelings, but I don't care.
But I love Tenacious D as a band. I know that you're not a fan because he drives you nuts. But, like, I absolutely love them. They're just super fun and just, like,
I
really
you
like
do.
Them.
I know.
I really wanted to see them when they were in town, like, 2 years ago, but I wasn't paying $88 to see Tenacious D. I'm sorry. This just wasn't going to happen.
No.
It's two guys.
I know, but I think...
And $88, though, I'm like, fuck that.
I'm surprised you didn't.
Just like last year, The Racketeers was on tour. I would have loved to have seen them. That would have been fucking amazing.
Right.
The problem is, it was $90 a fucking ticket. I'm like, no! Let's drive by raping for a band that had, like, four hits. It is! Like, I really liked them back in the day. Like, I really liked the Racketeers. But, like, they literally have, like, four hits.
I got ya.
They were only a band for two CDs.
I got ya.
So you're like, no, I'm not paying $90 for that. Granted, it is Jack Black singing. Or Jack White singing. And, like, we're just talking about Jack Black, okay? But
this
like
is Jack White, okay.
I really like Jack White though. Like as a singer, I think he's really
They're
good.
Like the yin and yang of Jacks.
I've thought of that, but still.
That's hilarious.
Maybe someday, when I have like my music sleeve, I will make somebody tattoo a Jack Black in black, and then Jack White with like a lighter tones,
like yin and
yang, and like a
style.
Circle thing, like with one of my like my mini portraits.
Oh
have
god.
One be Jack Black and have one be Jack White upside down.
Oh my god. Of course.
Wouldn't that be the most epic
okay,
thing ever, though?
It would be funny, and I'm not the one doing it, so like.
No, no, no. I won't make you do portraits.
No. There is no making me. That ain't happening. Ever. No, I'm good on that. Not my thing. I'm okay with that. I have come to terms with it, and I'm fine with it.
Right. Alright, it's about that time. Say goodbye.
Thanks for listening to our podcast.
Don't forget to subscribe, share, like, and follow. Remember, keep it wild.
Keep it creative.
And see you later.
Toodaloo, motherfuckers.